hard way, went a bit too far, so wrong. Oh no.
Hey, welcome in. I'm finally here to show you guys my apartment tour of my Portland, Oregon apartment. That's 533 square feet. I live in a one bedroom. And at the end, I'll tell you how much I pay for this place. But let's get started. We're here in my entryway, which is actually a great space because I've utilized a bunch of different areas. Of course, we have my lovely mask collection. I got this guy from Umbra. I'll try to link as many of the things mentioned in this video down below. So definitely check out the description box. But in this first closet, we've got my washer and dryer. And on the top, I just keep my suitcase and a blow up air mattress. And then on the other side, I have it as like a half pantry, half laundry room. And it's great because I have a lot of stuff to store. So I have all of my dried goods up here. And then I keep extra paper products, stuff for school, lots of like extra bags. This whole thing has all my cleaning products, my toolkit, some toys, and craft supplies at the very bottom. I wanted this area just to be kind of like my school section because I don't have an official desk in my apartment. So this houses all of my different pens and scissors, anything that I use for school is very organized in here. I got this off of Amazon. I just love that I can store so much in here. I have this cute little bin with a bunch of cards and mail that I like to save all my sentimental goods. And then on the bottom of these two drawers, I keep all of my nursing textbooks, anything that I need, my stethoscope, more school stuff, things that I file away. And then I've got my Bose home speaker. I love this speaker so much. It's got really great sound quality and we can hear it everywhere in the apartment, so that's fun. Of course, we've got my best friend picture and Katie's filming it. Isn't it? Good thing you took that. My badge right here for work, and then I have this sign that I got in Boise, Idaho that says the mountains are calling and I must go. I love to ski, so that's perfect. And then this was actually a graduation gift for my friend Scout. She hand embroidered this and it says onward, which I feel like is very fitting for 2020. It's just really appropriate. And then we've got this nice little picture from Urban Outfitters of lungs because I really like the cardiovascular system and I'm a medical nerd. It's true though, that's why I bought it. I'm gonna show you guys a little overview of my bedroom, but I actually already did an entire video that's touring everything in my bedroom, so I'll leave it linked up above. When I first toured this apartment, I actually thought, is a bed even gonna fit in here? But it did, and it's actually the perfect space for me. I don't really feel like I need any more space. I just sleep in here. I've got my closet. This is kind of my little getting ready station. My bed, obviously. My cute little plants. I think I'm gonna name those plants Harold and Gerald. I never announced them. But someone commented Harold and Gerald, and I thought that was really cute. Yeah, I'm gonna call them Harold and Gerald, and that's John B. And now we're gonna go on to the bathroom. This bathroom is super nice. I wanted it to be like very spa-like and luxurious, and I also wanted a lot of storage. So this is one of my favorite things that I purchased for the space. I got this at Bed Bath & Beyond, and I'll link it down below. It was super easy to build and everything. It's just this bamboo cabinet, and I'll store like extra Epsom salts, washcloths, more products. And it's a great place because it hides it all away. And then in these little bins, I just keep products that I'm trying out, different PR things that I'll give to my friends when they come over. We've got the toilet. This guy's from Target. It's made out of recycled plastic, which is kind of fun. My toilet paper holder. This is one of my favorite things up here. We've got this little guy and he says, "Have a good day." I got that from Society 6. I don't know, he just makes me really happy. And then we've got my shower. Got a full-size tub shower deal. The shower head's very nice. It kind of is like a little rainfall, and usually when I shower, I turn off one of these lights and I just shower with this light on. That's my shower. And then over here we have the vanity. We've got my little soap dispenser from Bath & Body Works. These little succulents. The middle guy unfortunately passed away. It's really hard to grow plants in a bathroom because it's very humid in here. So I try to move this out to the window so they can get some light and dry out. And I really don't even ever water them barely because they just get their own water from the room. And then we've got my little cotton balls, Q-tips here. These towels are all from Target. I love them a lot. They still sell them, so I'll definitely link those down below. This seems very disorganized, but I promise you it's organized. It's just got a lot going on down here. But I keep my hair stuff, products, nail polish, extra towels, medicine, literally everything I need to survive is in there. And then we've got these drawers. Now, the one really annoying thing about this apartment is that when the doors open, it's really hard to open these drawers. So I think that was a little bit of poor planning, but it's fine. I live with it. This top drawer has all of my everyday products. So I'll do like skincare in here, my toothbrush, toothpaste, everything, all the goods, and these drawer organizers are from IKEA, and they organize things very well. This literally fit perfectly in this drawer, so I was really excited about that. And then this one has all of my makeup. I keep most of my everyday makeup in my bedroom because I'll get ready at that little vanity area. But this has like extra products, or if I'm really gonna do my makeup, I'll go in here. And then the final drawer has my brush, lots of scrunchies, hair ties, clips, extra glasses, sunglasses, jewelry, you name it, it's all in there. That is a tour of my bathroom. I've also got a little hook behind the door, and it's so quiet in here now because I realized a little hack to fix my fan that goes off every time that it senses motion. So that was last night's project. I'm really excited that my little sticky note hack works. I don't know how long I'm gonna keep that on there, but for now it's been really quiet and I really like that. Now we've reached my little hallway section into my living room area. A lot of these things were from my old apartment. I have my kitty cat clock that my dad got me for my 19th birthday, and this is actually made in Portland, or found in Portland, I forget. There's a cool fact about it. And then I've got another little cacti set here, this little mini bar book series that my friends got me for my birthday this year, my watering can, a candle from my friend Miranda, this cute little bird sign from Society 6, more pictures of my friends. This little guy's from West Elm, and this is Nemo, my cactus that my dad got me when he was in California. And then these are fake, so I don't have to worry about them, and that's amazing. We have the wonderful, lovely living room that we've been waiting so long to see. And I'm really excited because I finally get to show you guys my article furniture. They were nice enough to send me this couch, this adorable pillow, and this dining room table and chair set. I was so excited to be able to work with them because I've been following them forever and love their Instagram and their products so much. This is the Sven 72-inch sofa. It's really hard to find small sofas for tiny spaces, and I went furniture shopping forever to try to find something that would look decent, and I just kept coming back to this one. So this is in the birch ivory color, and then it's got walnut legs that are really sturdy. This couch is so comfortable. Like, I think it's very cozy. These pillows, you can move them so you can like flip them over and refluff them, which I love. And it comes with these little round guys as well. It fits three people really comfortably, and I love it. And then this stool was actually in my old apartment. This is from Target, and it happens to match this so perfectly. So I kind of use this as my footstool, or I can like move it around if I want to put a dinner plate on it or something. This pillow is from Article as well. This is the Stitch pillow in pink. I just really liked how it added a little bit of texture and color to the room because I felt like it needed that. This little pillow, I haven't let myself decorate for Christmas quite yet, but I thought, you know, we're just gonna slowly start introducing the Christmas decor, winter decor in here. So I've got this here for now, but soon the Christmas decor will be coming. Of course, we have another lovely plant. This was from my manager as a graduation gift, and I love how it looks here. And then we've got my TV here. It's a little bit big for the space, but we're just making it work. And I found this from the Lounge Lizard in Portland. It was thrifted. It's a really cool store if you ever have the chance to go check it out. I just really liked the details in it, and I wanted something a little bit funky for the space. I also use it for storage. Not a ton of storage, but I'll have like some electronic stuff in here. Whole giant bin of blankets because all my friends and I love blankets and we love getting cozy, so we use literally every single one of those. And of course I have my charger in my living room. I think everyone needs that because it's great when people come over and want to charge their phone. Katie uses it, what, every single time you come
over? It's my charger. I call it my charger.
It's Katie's charger at this point. Oh, and this rug was actually in my old apartment in my bedroom, and we washed it out. It took a couple days to dry it, but it was worth it. It looks really fantastic in this space, and I felt like it needed just like a little rug, but I do love the hardwood floors. I really, really wanted a dining place to sit and eat our food at, and it was so hard to find something that was small. But this is the Mara Cafe table. It's got a real marble slab on top, so this thing is heavy and really amazing quality. That's what I love about all of the article stuff. Very high quality for an affordable price. It's got nice little oak legs, and it actually has something really cool in the legs where my dad and I, when we were putting the legs on this thing, you can twist the bottom, has like a cap on it, so you can level out the table, which is great because my building slopes ever so slightly that way. So we actually twisted that, so now it's super stable here, and I love that feature. So these are the Nosh dining chairs. I love chairs that are really comfortable. I sit in them like a normal chair, but then I can also, I'm weird, and I like to sit in my chairs like, you know, all curled up in a ball, so I love how comfortable they are, and the padded back and bottom is super super nice. I have my little basil plant here. I just repotted him, so I feel like he's kind of going through a lot right now. If you guys have name suggestions for him, my basil plant needs a name.
That's gonna make him too hard to eat. We can't name him.
Maybe he'll just be Basil, Sir Basil. I have Sir Basil on this placemat from Crate & Barrel, just as a little added piece of decor, because we love styling. I just thought this whole area turned out really well, because I loved the cafe table with the little shelves. It makes it feel like you actually are in a little French cafe. These shelves are from West Elm. This little guy is a teapot that Katie's family got me for my birthday this year, and I thought it looked so cute. I got some fake plants here, and some little cooking books. This is a Timberline candle, you guys know. Timberline's my favorite. Well, the place I learned how to ski, it's not my favorite place to ski, but it reminds me of Timberline, and it smells like Christmas.
I want to smell.
Yeah, it smells really good.
Oh my god.
We can find it.
Yeah.
It smells really good. So I got that at one of the local stores in the area. And then on the very top, we have Katie's favorite part of the apartment. And my dad's probably. My dad made me this light for my birthday this year, and it's got a camera on it. He thrifted the camera and then mounted the whole setup. He's very crafty. It's honestly, it's probably one of my favorite things he's ever made. Love that piece, and it's really nice at night because we'll just turn that one on and the mood lighting's very wonderful. This little candle holder is from Crate & Barrel, and then we've got a frame of my friends Keegan and Emma. They both have YouTube channels, so go subscribe to them. That was from our LA trip, and I love that picture of us. This is also from Crate & Barrel. And then we have this piece, which was a really lucky home goods find. So I got this when I moved into my first apartment a couple years ago, and I just love the way it looks. I like the texture inside, but oh, I never talked about the windows. We have a whole wall of windows in this place. So although we're filming this and it's very backlit, I promise you when you're hanging out in here, the lighting is very, very nice. And I love that we have the shades so we can like lower them for privacy. Otherwise, everyone sees in here. If you guys have been following my videos for a long time and you watched the whole moving process of me setting up this apartment, you will remember the dresser that was supposed to go in my bedroom but didn't fit. Well, this is now our drink dresser, and it ended up working out really well. Wouldn't you agree? Like, this is a much better use of it. Kitchen, this is my stool that I used to get around everywhere. I just put it there. It's not the most aesthetic, but it's very practical. So. I love this stool, by the way. I'll link it down below. And we've got this mirror from IKEA centered over it. This dresser's from West Elm. It's full of different drinks, you know what I mean? It's really great.
We do not need this many beverages.
We do, though. We go through them so fast. I just keep them well stocked. Okay, last night the coffee was on sale, so I got some more.
Okay.
We do have a lot of teas because I love tea, and Katie's been drinking more coffee than I have been here because I'm not trying to get addicted to the coffee. That's the best drawer, honestly. And then this drawer, we just keep a bunch of other drink shenanigans. Bottom drawer is really random. In this drawer, I just keep my athletic clothes because I love my athletic clothes. And I was running out of storage, so it's a little bit of a mixed match, but it's fine. I call these my emergency wines. It's like they are decor, but you know, when you're having a really rough day, friends are coming over, they're always here for you. This one's really artsy. I got this from Whole Foods. It's called like Lolia or something. I don't know, it looks like a perfume bottle. It's very nice. And then this is Pool Boy, and it's in a plastic bottle, which is really cool because you can travel with it. My friend Miranda got me hooked on this Pool Boy, so this is like my third Pool Boy. And then we've got little coasters that Miranda also got me as a graduation gift. Oh, another, I have so many great graduation gifts in here. This is from my friend Emma Romano. They're these glasses that have maps of Eugene. There's one yellow one and one green one. So I went to University of Oregon, and I love these so much. We have this little cocktail party book that Katie Mack got me for Christmas.
I don't know.
I think that was a Christmas.
It was a long time ago.
We have my lovely simple human trash can, and then we have the kitchen. I'm gonna show you guys some of the cabinets because I love being nosy and seeing what's inside people's cabinets. Huge shout out to my friend Leah for helping me organize this because it was a really large task. In this little guy, we have lots of spices. I only have three drawers in this whole kitchen, so this organizer's from IKEA and it holds my spices really well, and I can still pull it out. I have another one down here with more spices, and then the bottom shelf is all of my kitchen linens. We've got sauces galore, spices galore in here. My favorite oil and vinegar stand that my parents got me for Christmas. I use this all the time. I think everyone needs one. And
that's what I want for Christmas.
It's great. Uh-oh. I'm not getting you that. This guy's from West Elm. I have this little butter dish from Target. Some random storage for like saran wrap, and these things up here. This is pretty much my pantry. We've got lots of snacks here. You know, my secret candy stash that I try not to tap into. My go-go squeezes, because I'm literally obsessed and I have them every morning. And then my canned goods, we've got pastas, and then extra sauces and things that are stored as backups up top. We've got my Smeg toaster, and then this is a little spoon rest that matches my utensil holder from West Elm. We've got this fruit dish from Target. Then in here, we've got all of my plates, bowls, these little ramekin things that we use for dipping sauces all the time. And then on the very top shelf, we have more specialty cooking glassware. And here we've got all the cups, mugs, and then reusable cups on the very top. Down here on the countertop, we have this cute little fake plant that Emma got me. And then we've got paper towels, my trusty Keurig, some sugar. This little container is from IKEA. I've had this since I started college, and I love it because it holds a little baby Dawn, and then I can just refill this guy. Some soap, a little sponge, my lovely scrubber brush, a huge sink, which is so amazing. I love the fact that there's not a divider in it, so I can just wash everything all at once. The only bummer about this kitchen is there's really not a great place to store pots and pans. So this is kind of a mess, if you will. For Christmas, I think I'm gonna ask for some sort of like organizing system that will like sort things so I don't pull out a pot and make a tsunami of pots to come out towards me, because it happens all the time. Silverware in this drawer, got all of my knives and gadgets in this drawer. And the bottom drawer has more of our baking goods, mason jars, measuring cups, things like that. Got my shopping list on my fridge. That way I can just jot things down as I need them. And we'll show you inside the fridge. It's really not exciting. I've been doing a good job not wasting food, mm-hmm. eating at my food. So I don't have a lot in here right now, but semi-organized. I lost my fridge organizers at my old apartment, so I'm still mourning the loss of them, and maybe I'll rebuy them. My freezer down here, and I love that I have a whole ice machine. I bought this little scooper from the container store, which is great, because then I just, you know, scoop it directly into my hydro, and I stay hydrated. And then we've got this Portland sign. This was another Home Goods find, and I thought, you know, now that I live in Portland, how fitting that I have a sign to let everyone know. Oh, and the last thing, this was a great idea from Leah, because I was like, what am I gonna put up here? And I had all of these bins, and so she actually organized my Tupperware in these bins, which was really great because I can pull them out really easily. And then I've got my juicer, blender, extra stuff up there. And that is when I get my fancy little step stool out, because I need that. Oh, I was gonna tell you guys how much I pay. Great part about this apartment is that I don't have to pay for parking, and parking in Portland is usually $150 to $200 a month, so I actually saved that and was able to get this one bedroom, which normally costs $17.79 a month, but because I got 2 months free during the COVID time, I actually pay $14.82 a month for the first year. That's how much I pay for rent in this place. It's a brand new building. No one's ever lived here, which is really great. It's 2020 build. And so far, it's been a fantastic experience. I love the location. Comment of the day. Do you guys live in a small space or a big space, and which do you prefer? Make sure you guys are following me on Instagram if you're not already. I post a lot of Portland content, and it's just at Kiara Madisen. I love interacting with you guys on there, and if you're not subscribed already, make sure to subscribe. Thank you guys so much for watching, and thank you so much for Article for sending me such amazing furniture. I also wanted to mention that they have free shipping on orders over $999, or on any orders, they have a flat rate shipping of $49 for most places in the US or Canada, which is amazing because I paid hundreds of dollars in shipping prices to ship from other places, and I hate spending money on shipping. Thank you guys for watching this video, and I will talk to you guys later. What am I gonna say? I don't wanna be cheesy.
Okay, ready? Just go now.
With some plants that I may have, you know, borrowed from a display, a fall display. I only worry that I'm crazy, 'cause if it's all true, I mean, you know I ain't lying, 'cause I hate wasting time. You said